G'day, welcome back to Calc and Do. In today's episode of Must Haves, we'll look specifically at table scripts. Let's look at changing the contents of a table. We'll start with the table to the top left, and we want to add some content for the sake of the demonstration. Normally in a text frame, you can right click and go fill with placeholder text. But you can't do that in a table. This is where a script called Tomaxxi Fill Table comes into play. There's a variety of options to choose from, but we're going to choose numbers from 1 to 100 for reasons that'll become apparent shortly. However, the table data that I would need is actually in the table to the bottom right. So I should just be able to copy and paste these values into the new table, right? Not quite. It's put the values in, but I've lost my formatting. What I'd like to do is copy these values and paste it while retaining the formatting. So I'll copy the values that I want with the formatting how I'd like it to be applied. Select the cells I'd like to replace, and then run pop tab unleashed. And the new values have come in. I'd now like to sort these values based on the first column, but have everything in the subsequent columns to follow the position of the first column. I can use this script from Peter Caro called Table Sort, making sure I have a blinking cursor in any one of the cells. I right click. I'd like it to sort on the first column. It's numeric. There's one header row. And click OK. And we can see that it sorted it. And all the other information has followed its original position based on the first column. I'd now like to apply what's called a heat map. It will fill each cell with a tint value based on the value in the cell, much like conditional formatting in Excel. First, I need to give it a value of 100% tint of the color that I'd like it to become. Using my black arrow tool, selecting the frame, I then run the table heat map script. And when I go back to my swatches, we can see that the swatch values correspond with the values in each cell. Pretty cool, huh? But I'm going to undo that. On second thought, all I really need to do is highlight any cells that have a value higher than 80. What I'll do is I'll apply a specific style that I've made ahead of time. So to do this, I highlight the cells that I'd like to search, and then I run the script REGEX Cell Style. Now it'll ask me to type in a GREP expression. So for this GREP expression, I'm going to type in 8, followed by another number, or 9 followed by another number, or 100. And I'd like to apply the cell style of danger. It then tells me how many cells are affected. Click OK. So now all these cells that met that criteria now have the cell style of danger applied to them. I'd like to add a row which will provide me totals of each column. I quickly make a new row by clicking and holding the last row and then with my option key drag down a new row. I now want the totals to be at the bottom of these columns. Using the Calculs Raynaux script to do this, I highlight the cells that I'd like to add and run the script. I now have a new dialog box that asks what operation I'd like to run. In this case, I'd like to run addition. I'd like to apply it to the selected cells. There's no rounding that I need to have, nor do I need to apply any separators or apply any currency. And click OK. And that gives me the total of 384. There is an issue with the script. It doesn't understand words. So if we want to do this table quickly, I have to cut the header row out, highlight the table, run the script, and go all columns. I can then add my header row back in, but I have to reformat the header row. That's it for another video. If you got something out of this video, show me by hitting the like button and subscribe for more great videos. Check out ColCanDo or InDesign Secrets for the latest articles, or tweet me at ColCanDo. Until next time, I'll see you later.